Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Look at someone and smile this morning. To the book of Psalm number 148, Psalm number 148, and let us stand out of reverence for God's holy word, and listen now for the word of the Lord. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Focus.
Focus.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the highest. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens and you heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord. For he commanded and they were created. He established them forever and ever. He fixed their bounds which cannot be cast. Praise the Lord from the earth, ye sea monsters and all these fire and hail, snow and frost, stormy winds, fulfilling his command. Mountains. and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds. Kings of the earth and all people, princes and all rulers of the earth, young men and women alike, old and young together, let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His glory is above earth and heaven. He has raised up a horn for his people, praise for all of his faithful. For the people of Israel who are close to him, for the people of Pacoima First United Methodist Church who are close to him, praise the Lord.
Amen.
This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. Look at your name and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
We're going to focus today on praise.
Praise.
Look at somebody else and say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Everybody.
Everybody.
Scripture not only says everybody, but God loves praise so much that he even says everything. Praise. My beloved, it is my hope and my prayer that we become a church growing in our praise to the Lord each and every Sunday. Each and every Sunday, I see it. Now somebody might say that, well, we've always praised the Lord. And that's good. But let me tell you about God. There's always more. There's always more. So somebody might ask, why is praise so important? Well, because praise is more than important. Praise is critical. It's critical to our Christian faith, and it is just imperative. Because the Bible says in our scripture text that the purpose, say purpose.
Purpose.
Some of us are looking for our purpose in life. I'm going to help you today. I'm going to tell you what your purpose is, what my purpose is, what your purpose is. Our purpose of our creation is to praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Our purpose is to praise. Isaiah 43:21, God declared, the people that I formed for myself. Did his name say, that's you? Did the other one say, that's me?
That's me.
The people that I formed for myself, that they proclaim my praise. Praise is the reason for the existence of the entire universe, the sun, the moon, the stars, the trees, the ocean, the sea, the grass, the flowers, the bugs, the snakes, the alligators. And let me repeat, praise is the reason that you and I exist. We were created to praise the Lord. Say, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
And so this morning, we're going to examine and practice. Somebody say, practice.
Practice.
We're going to examine and practice the words of praise. We're going to learn how we're supposed to act in God's church. We're going to learn about praise. Somebody say, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise. Now, the scripture came to us in their original form in Hebrew and in Greek, and of course in seminaries, Hebrew and Greek are required. I won't tell you about my class in Greek because it's not a lovely story. Amen. The Bible is written Greek. And so without understanding the Hebrew and Greek words, you really can't understand the Bible in its original form. But I do want to insist, on the other hand, that observations now of the original meaning of the words in Hebrew and Greek can provide us with real valuable insight and can serve to enhance our understanding of praise. Now many of us have not even been in a church where the pastor preached about praise. I don't remember growing up hearing a pastor preach about praise. Maybe that's why the people were so quiet in the church that I grew up in. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. I know that y'all didn't, but I grew up in a little Methodist Episcopal church where if you made some noise, the ushers would ask you if you needed something.
Right.
Quiet! It was sophisticated! It was professional! And those people just don't act any kind of way, somebody said. So let me share with you today, and with me, the study of God's Word. Say, Pastor. That's your job. And so here we go. The first word of praise in the Old Testament in Hebrew is halal, halal, halal. It means to be loud, to be boast, to rave, to celebrate God. And so we have this word in the English language, in the translation of hallelujah. Hallelujah, it means simply praise the Lord. It means praise Yah. The Old Testament Yahweh translation. And the King James Version of the Bible is Jehovah. And again, the word halal means to be boastful about God, to be excited about God, and to enjoy God. This word means to show a tremendous explosion of enthusiasm in the act of praising God. It's what you do. You know about praise. Don't tell me you don't know about praise, cuz the world praises all the time. It praises things and people. Most we praise today in America is, of course, sportsmanship. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You know, like I know, that in a football game, people are focused. They focus on the game. When something good happens, they know how to praise. You can't tell a Methodist from a Baptist, from a Pentecostal, from a Presbyterian, from a Lutheran when it comes to praising a football team. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
They don't have no guilt. They ain't got no shame. They don't hold back on nothing when it comes to praising a football team. Oh, but in some churches, when you hallow the Lord, others may think you're being foolish. But in most churches, we're not hallowing the Lord. We're just doing whatever we want to do. Hallowing the Lord is something different. It's what you're supposed to do in church, and people may look at you funny. But you're only doing what you've been instructed to do in the Word of God. And I keep saying, how is it that you beg people to do what God says do, and yet they say they love God? How can you love God and not do what God says do? You're praising God because you're overwhelmed with love that you feel.
Yes.
Falling in love.
Yes.
With Jesus. Not Tyrone. Falling in love with Jesus. Should have known that a long time ago. It's the best thing I've ever done.
Yes.
said, I would be ashamed to praise the Lord. Be ashamed of yourself if you come in here and don't praise the Lord. Don't ever be ashamed or timid to hello the Lord this morning by loudly repeating after me. Loudly say, I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
So the next word in biblical teaching about praising God is yada. Say yada.
Yada.
And guess what? Yada means to worship with extended hands. Well, you see that in so many churches today. Now it's getting to the place that it's not just the black church, but it's all churches who are in touch with God in this day of Pentecost. That they're doing what the Bible says to do and taking out what they used to do, acting like the world they are doing. When you see people with their hands lifted up, they're just being obedient to the word of God, following the worship style of God's people. By yada, yada means to raise your hands. Yada means to throw up your hands. Yada means to acknowledge and pull. Psalm 131, I will give God thanks. With all of my heart, I will sing praises to God before all the small g-gods. Like football, no, they just small g-gods. You know, we make famous people out small g-gods. We listen to people who don't even go to church, but they on the television. They got a whole lot. You listen to what they say. We make people, our God. I was telling others when I raised my hand, but I'm saying anything, what God has done. And so this verb has a root meaning of extended hands or to throw out the hand. It implies worshiping with raised hands. Make your hands do what God wants them to do. Hands are important. We learn about hands in our culture. Our culture teaches sign language in many ways. If you're in front of me acting a little crazy, and I do this, I don't have to say nothing. If you're talking in the symphony and I do, if you're way off and I'm trying to get your attention, I have to say much. If I'm leaving and I say, somebody say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Open day, I love to think of raising my hands to God as a baby that extends her hands to a loving mama, a daddy. Here I am. Heard preacher, teaches church, that you lift up hands because you're saying, God, I surrender, and God, whatever you have for me, I will receive it. So you can't receive nothing with your hands like this. People try to give you money, I bet you don't have to work. But if you really want to be blessed,
yeah,
then you'll say to God, because when praises go on, blessings. Lord, I'm going to catch my blessings this morning.
Yes, yes.
Say, I will lift up my hands and praise. So another word of praise in Hebrew is barak. Barak. I like that. Barak. The word barak means to bless. Bless, to declare God is the origin or power for success and prosperity and fertility. One of the most interesting words for praise in the whole Old Testament, because to understand for walk is to count for blessings. Count them one by one. Count your many blessings and just see what God has done. And then just give me a minute, because I'm in a Barak attitude right here. Right now, I'm Baraking God. Right now, I'm looking at all the things I have, and I'm Baraking God. I'm thanking Him for being so good to me. Barak. We have all been blessed by God. Everyone, we have all been received yet. You can bless God on creation. You can bless God for what you don't have, but you know God, and you know that you will have.
That's right. Exactly.
Because when praise is God, what? Every now and then we need to get down on our knees and pray, church. We need to get down on our knees and pray. And now the next word for praise is Zamah. Somebody say Zamah. See, some of y'all, the name y'all babies. Zamah. Isn't that true? Zamah means to pluck the strings of an instrument. Darnell knows how to live in Zamar. Zamar means to pluck the strings of an instrument. Zamar means to praise with songs. To praise with song.
This is one of the musical verbs for praise in the book of Psalms. It carries the idea of making music and praise to God. As in Psalm 92:1, it is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises unto thy name.
It's impossible to understand praise without understanding its relationship to music. To music. Two things that must happen in a church for people. When I say people, I'm talking about a whole lot of people. For people to come, for people to stay, for people to keep coming, and for people to keep staying, and as people go, let others come. It's the word and music. Because you see, music prepares the way. Music fixes the heart. It softens your heart before God comes with his word. I love music because God loves music. And if you want good music, you got to pay for good music. Somebody say amen. You got to respect musicians, choirs, because they are part of ushering in the Spirit of the Lord. The word Zamar means to touch the strings and refers to praise that involves instrumental worship expressed in Psalm 150. Psalm 150 says, praise him with trumpet sound. Praise him with lute and harp. Charging a whole lot of money
know, one of the things they do now is to ask you, shout.
Shout.
You have to pay a lot of money. Don't listen, Kyle. And he says, let it all out. Just shout. Shout. Sometimes they put a pillow at the chair and say, talk, shout it. Shout. Get it out. One of the reasons we are so depressed and we so sick and we so, you know, strange. With all the things we have, it's because we don't go to God's house looking for God's healing by just worshiping and praising Him. As the Bible says, pray. To shout. This word is found in Psalm 117. Oh, praise the Lord!
Glory!
Shema!
Glory!
Shema!
Glory!
praise is toda. We just got one more. Say toda, toda. W-D-A-H, toda. It's related to the word yada. And it's translated as thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is also involved in extension of hands, and adoration is used in the book of Psalms to thank God for things that have not yet happened, as well as for those things already completed. Do you ever thank God for the things that have not yet happened, the good things that are coming? Toda is directly related to the concept of praise as an act of faith. Mercy's called the other day. People were saying, Pastor, why do good people die? Why does all this happen? Why all these people? Why? I said, you know, how could the prophet was why do the righteous get everything and the good people don't get nothing? And God said, how the just shall live. As I'm going to praise God for my healing while I'm still sick. I'm going to praise God for money in the bank while I'm temporarily out of cash. Yeah. I'm going to praise God for my new car while I call Uber or while I sit in the bus stop. And finally, the word rule. Old Testament, a believer had no problem with getting very excited about the reality of his relationship with God, as expressed in Psalm 95:1. Let us make a joyful what? Noise. Prayer to the Lord. Let's make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. And Psalms 101 says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Some people come to church shouting. Some people, they ain't coming to church to gossip and talk about it and criticize it. They ain't coming, that's what they coming for. Because they love God. They coming to church to shout. They shout before they got here. That's where I want to be someday. That's where I want to be someday. Just one call of his name. I'm living shout. Just one song in the choir. And I'm ready to shout. Oh, that's where I'm gonna be someday. Have you ever been in a church where the Holy Ghost would come and people would just fall down shouting? I was in a church. One of our pastors going on the Tuesday of Kansas. I went there to preach, and guess what happened? I thought, these people just thought the pastor ain't eating. And they ran and shouted. They didn't say nothing. But what got me was that doing the doxology, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Nearly all 1,000 of them started shouting. I said, these people shouting on the doxology. Man, that's serious. That's serious business. My beloved child of God, as I close, I hope that you see from our study of the Psalms that praising God is not optional. And the devil will put everything in your path, in your mind, in your heart, to keep you from praising God. He'll tell you all kinds of lies. People gonna talk about you. They gonna talk about you anyway. I want them to talk about me because I praise. You don't talk about me. Talk about me because I praise the Lord.
Yes.
Lord, keeps me up at night. I'm for many hours praise is not something nice to do whenever you feel like it. Or you think that it doesn't do it now. Others think it's not proper. Amazes me the improper things people do in church, and then they come in church and don't praise him at all. You don't know what improper is. It's just proper not to praise the Lord. And I'm glad to know that. I hope and pray that you didn't even learn or relearn or realize that praising God is our highest calling. It is our purpose. And if we are not continually filled with praise to God, then we are not yet fulfilling the purpose which God created us for. We're not being grateful to God for saving us from our sins. And so, I say to you this morning, and I say to all of us, afflicted by anything, praise the Lord. In your life. Choir, help us today. Give the Lord total praise. Look at his name and say, focus.